This video is supported in part by Retro Days, a place for nostalgia nerds to gather, share memories, chat, and engage. Go to RetroDays.com or check their YouTube channel linked below.
Listenership in audio podcasts has been on the rise for the last several years and continues to grow. But if you're like a lot of Generation Xers, you might have felt left out of this thing. It just passed you by or went over your head. Well, if you're one of those folks that doesn't know about audio podcasts or would like to know how to get started, this video is for you. Don't you know that you're a grown up? No games, no puns. Not allowed if you're a grown up. Hey there, welcome back to Gen X Grown Up. I'm John, I'm a Gen X Grown Up, and I want to thank you for checking out this video and the rest of the channel. So yeah, audio podcasts is something that's been sweeping the nation, even the world. But oddly enough, Generation Xers, a people of our age group, demographic, generation, statistically are among the least represented in audio listenership. And that seemed odd to me because we were the generation who evolved from the analog to digital age. And podcasting is a purely digital medium, and we adapted so well to the rest of the digital revolution. Why not podcasting? I'm frankly at a loss for how Generation Xers specifically missed out on this one digital revolution when we did such a great job of migrating to all of the others. I myself am a huge fan of podcasts. I listen regularly. You may or may not know that Gen X Grown Up has a regular podcast. It comes out every week. We cover media, games, tech, toys, pop culture, and nostalgia of particular interest by and for Generation Xers. When we attend conventions as Gen X Grown Up and we tell people about that show, very often the answer we get back is, I've really never heard of podcasts, I don't know how to listen, or I'm not sure where to get started. This video is intended to help you. There's a veritable ocean of free entertainment just waiting for you. We're gonna run through the who, what, when, where, why, and how of podcasting, and when it's over, you will know exactly how to get started and find some great shows to get you started. Let's get going right away then with the what of podcasts. So what exactly is a podcast? What are we talking about here? Now there are several types, but we're talking specifically about audio podcasts. These are pre-recorded shows that are put out on the internet for you to download and listen to. And there is a raft of them out there. The term podcast first kind of cropped up around 2004, and it's a combination of iPod broadcast. When iPod was the predominant audio listening device, people would start recording and putting out little shows that you could listen to, download on your iPod. And because of the very grassroots origin of podcasting, it has become a real kind of democratization, a liberation of publishing. Anyone can start and put out a podcast. Because of that, there's a lot of garbage out there, but with anything of this nature, there are actually a lot of hidden gems out there to be found amongst podcasting. And if you're not listening to any of those, you're probably missing out on something that you otherwise would be very interested in and just didn't know was available. An easy parallel, a way to think of it, think of podcasts as like Netflix for audio. There's tons of content out there ready for you to binge, new stuff coming all the time, and it's all free. Well, I say free, but that has an asterisk. 99% of podcast content is completely free. There are some big shows that put some of their special features, special content behind a paywall, either exclusive or for like early release before it hits the public. But by and large, most of the stuff is available completely free without any barrier of entry. All right, let's move on to the who of podcasts. To answer the question who, we're really talking about three topics. Who's creating shows, who are they for, and who's listening? As I mentioned, anyone can create shows. Anyone from the big boys like your NPR and CNN or major network, all the way down to knuckleheads like us at Gen X Grown Up. Who these shows are intended for, well, that's as diverse as the people creating them. In some cases, it's a very broad spectrum. We're talking about news or fitness or sports are very broad topical things. Many more shows are very narrow cast. They're very niche. They're talking to a specific interest group. Now on to that third question of who is actually listening today. Well, you know the Nielsen Group, the people that track television ratings? Well, they're also now tracking podcasting as it's on the rise. According to their numbers, 55% of individuals in the U.S. have listened to at least one audio podcast. But that's where the numbers start to drop off precipitously. Fewer than 25% listen regularly. About 16% listen every single week. They're avid fans. And the numbers drop off even further for Generation Xers like us. As I mentioned, what we're trying to fix in this very video to get us on the ball. All right, let's move on then to the why of podcasts. So why listen to podcasts? Well, I'm not trying to convince you to do something you don't want to do in this video. I'm really just trying to expose you to something that if you are an audience for, I don't want you to miss out like so many of us have done over the past several years. But there are a number of reasons you might want to consider listening to podcasts. Because of the democratization that I mentioned of who can put out a show, it means that everyone has a voice. So podcasting means you can get a very diverse spectrum of people's opinions and viewpoints and educate yourself and expose yourself to things that might not otherwise be in the regular media or on broadcast television or radio, for that matter. Speaking specifically for myself, I'll tell you that what I get out of podcasting is almost entirely the entertainment value. I listen to shows based on topics that I find interesting or people that I find entertaining or amusing. And because it's such a broad spectrum of who's putting that out, you're going to find something that's for you, as I mentioned before. And maybe the best answer to the question why is another question, why not? It doesn't cost you anything to try it. You have nothing to lose. If you're willing to click a few buttons on your smartphone screen and put in your earbuds, you can sample podcasting and see if it's right for you or not. All right, if any of this has stacked up a willingness for you to try, but you think, I'm really not sure if I have the time, next up is the where of podcasting. The where and the when of listening to podcasts kind of go hand in hand, but let's tackle the where first. And that's twofold. First, where can you listen in terms of devices? Reality is, whatever you're using to watch this video on now is perfect for listening to podcasts. Your phone, your tablet, your Alexa, your Kindle, your PC, your Mac, whatever it is, you can go natively on a web browser or use a dedicated podcast app. When we get to the end of this video, to the how, I'll show you exactly how to get started listening to a show. The second part of where is, where are people generally when they listen to the show? And that plays into the true beauty of podcast listening, which is it's a multitasking experience. You can do it when you're driving or when you're exercising or when you're gaming or when you're working or when you're walking. Pretty much any time that you're not using your ears, but you do need your other senses, you can devote your audio senses to podcasting, intake some entertainment while you're doing other things. So really, you can layer podcasting on top of what you already do to add more enjoyment. So it's not about finding time, it's about allowing yourself to add podcasts to make the time you already spend more enjoyable. I said these go together, so let's go on to the when of podcasts. The when of listening to podcasts, we kind of already touched on just a second ago, and where when you listen is pretty much anywhere you are not busy with your ears or want to add entertainment into your life. When do shows come out is the other part of when. Every single show has a different release schedule. Some are every single day, some are weekly or bi-weekly or monthly. Some shows have long since stopped being produced. But the great thing about those shows is they continue to exist on the internet for you to download months or years even after they've stopped being put out. So in all likelihood, if you do find a show that you enjoy, there are probably dozens, if not hundreds, of back episodes ready for you to binge anytime you're ready for them. Okay, if you've made it this far and you're ready to jump into the world of listening to podcasts, it's time to move on to the how. So let's tackle what is often the last and largest barrier for most people. That's the how. How do you actually get to listen? What are the mechanics? I've got my Android tablet here, but what we walk through is going to be largely the same whether you have an Android or iOS or any other kind of operating system. So first we need an app to listen to podcasts. There are some default ones, but I'm going to guide you to one called Pocket Casts. I'm going to jump into the Play Store and I'm going to search for Pocket, all one word, Casts. And there it is at the top. So I already have it installed. You, of course, would click install. I'm gonna click open. So this is a list of all the podcasts I'm currently subscribed to. The reason I pointed out Pocket Casts in general, take a look at this Discover tab at the bottom. So you can browse through most commonly listened to or popular podcasts, what's trending, to find things that other people have said they obviously enjoy. You can come down and go by category, whether you want arts, business, comedy, education. You can see all the different categories available here for you. So you could go into comedy, for example, and see what's big in there. Because we are Gen X grown-up, let's go and subscribe, though, to the Gen X grown-up podcast. I'm going to hit the little magnifying glass for search, and I'm going to start typing Gen X grown-up, and there it is, right at the top. We just click on it, click the subscribe button on the side, and you are subscribed and ready to roll. If you look back on the main page, your new one will be added here at the bottom. I'll pick Gen X grown-up. I'll scroll through and find an episode that I'm interested in. Hey, how about this one all about record clubs? I'll click play. And with that, you are officially a podcast listener. It's just that simple. And listen, if you find some great podcasts that you hadn't before, or if this video helps indoctrinate you into the world of listening to audio shows like this, I would love to hear about it in the comments down below. I really hope you found something to enjoy in this video, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.
Gen X Grown Up is dedicated to bringing you new Generation X-inspired videos every week. Here are a couple more you can watch right now, but for even more, subscribe and enable those notifications. And if you love what we do, we invite you to support us over on Patreon. And of course, your feedback in the comments and a quick thumbs up are always appreciated.